This completes the performance part of basketball, and high school is concerned, but they have one more task to perform, and that's the sight reading. And instead of moving an 8-gallon band back into a band room with all its accompanying instruments and paraphernalia, we're going to have that done right here. So if you'll bear with us, they will have their sight reading task now. After which we'll have the reading of all the grades for that.
Still a little bit small, this is measure 55. You got the common market there, and there's other common support. Things deserve, maybe 65. Common mark, so we can take a break, Alto Sax from solo at 56. And it's hard, it's hard and oboe. Count down the morning, oboe, 56. The bottom 59, looking at your 60. Start at 60, after the bottom. It's fast. Four and one, three and two.
Thank you.
District Rating 2. Office Middle School, Grade 2, Rating 1. Palatine High School, Playing Grade 2 Music, Rating 2. Matoaka High School, Playing Grade 3 Music, Rating 3. Colonial High School, Grade 3 Music, Rating 2. Brunswick High School, Rating 2, Grades 2 and 3, Rating 3. Oakwell High School, Playing Grade 3 Music, Rating 2. Carver Middle School, Playing Grade 3 Music, Rating 1. Buckingham High School, Grade 3 Music, Rating 3. Providence Middle School, Playing Grade 3 Music, Rating 1. Swift Creek Middle School, Playing Grade 3, Rating 1. Amelia County High School, Playing Grade 4, Rating 3. Meadowbrook High School, Playing Grade 4, Rating 1. Central of Lunenburg, Playing Grade 4, Rating 2. Hopewell High School, this is the Symphonic Band, Playing Grade 4, Rating 2. All of these are symphonic bands now, this is their first band. Midlothian High School, Playing Grade 4, Rating 2. Randolph Henry High School, Playing Grade 4 Music, Rating 2. Clover Hill High School, Playing Grade 4, Rating 1. Lloyd C. Byrd High School, Playing Grade 4 and 5, Rating 1. Manchester High School, Playing Grade 5, Rating 1. Palatine High School, Playing Grade 4 and 5, Rating 1. Meadowbrook High School, Playing Grade 5, Rating 1. Monacan High School, Playing Grade 5, Rating 2. Thomas Dale High School, Playing Grade 5 and 6, Rating 2. Midlothian High School, Playing Grade 5 and 6, a unanimous 1.
Thank you. Okay, we'll go into a little more formal setting now with the symphonic band. That was the Alfred Reed Hounds of Spring, comparatively new piece of music, but very popular with the kids also. The next one is a little bit older tune in band repertoire called Procession of Nobles by Rimsky-Korsakov. Thank you. third heavy in a row here. Trying to give the kids a lot of different styles, reaching into a lot of the repertoire of what we refer to as standard band literature. I like to give them a full scope of it. So this next number leans a little bit more towards the contemporary side, the Mask by Francis Macbeth. And I don't know, we kind of like to play it. It's kind of a game to see how fast we can play it. Hopefully we won't play that game too much tonight. Mask.
Thank you.
Steve, can you all hear this? If I just like to stand up straight, because I've tried this before and it worked. Take a little break in the action now to make a couple of announcements and recognize a few people. The first one is to inform you that if you would like to have a set tape of a program tonight, there are order blanks in the foyer as a remembrance of the evening, especially if one of your kids is seniors, and even if they're not, for prosperity. I know I have some of my tapes, my, I hate to use that word, old high school, but I have some former tapes that I have played in, and they are meaningful later on in life. So if you'd like to have a tape, the order forms are in the back, and we invite you to take one of the order forms. They will be mailed directly to your house, so you don't have to worry about me making contact with the kids. They will be mailed directly to your house by the sign recording. Bowling's down here in the corner now doing his job. First I would like to do is recognize the senior parents. These are parents that are graduating seniors, I guess you could say. Some of these have had several kids in the group, but some of their younger kids haven't got up to this point yet. So we're going to say until we see you later. Hopefully they will be back a little bit later. But I would like you to stand to be recognized. These parents that really, I've said it before, and I'll be saying it forever, I suppose. I could not run this program by myself. There's no way anybody can. It's too large. It's too diversified. I need help. And the help has come from in the form of our band leaders. And these parents have done so much. It would be too long to list them all. But they are the ones that are responsible for us being, for the third time in a row, the only Chesterfield band, the only band in the district to be named 3 years in a row as Honor Band of Virginia. These parents have been kind of ringleaders, my crying child, and everything else that you can imagine. I would like to first recognize Mr. Yao. If you would stand, please, Mr. and Mrs. Yao. This is their baby that's graduating. She's going to throw a dart at me for saying that. Their youngest is graduating this year. And then Mr. and Mrs. Hinge. Follow the red light, I think you can see Mary's still in action there. I guess it's their middle child is graduating, and they still have one coming up, but she's just a little too young to get into force into high school right now. Another one of our parents who was inadvertently left out of the program, and I don't think she's here tonight. She doesn't have a child in the program right now. Her daughter had to drop out, but she has stayed on. She has been our treasure, and she's kept our noses clean financially. And I would like to recognize her in absentia. This is Kathy Hooper. Looking at the kids saying, oh yeah, there's one there. Another parent that has a set of parents that have done so much for us, Mr. and Mrs. Witter. Okay, Ms. Yao, you may have to help me on this because I'm neglected in the program. Thank you. Here she is again. Okay, thank you. That's and save me again. And we all have a family that's been so just really very instrumental, not no time really. Mr. and Mrs. Al Ross. Mr. and Mrs. Gil Forcier. Their names are in the program, and if you see them afterwards, please extend your appreciation, because they have done so much in front of the scenes and behind the scenes to help us. At this time, I would like to call upon Mrs. Yao again. Or do you have the announcements for the scholarship? Oh, Mrs. DeNunzio, I'm sorry. From one president, Yao is our outgoing president, and Mrs. DeNunzio is our incoming president there. And Joel, you better let her by, or you'll never let her down. Pull the simple away. Well, I think this microphone's going to fit somebody.
Every year the Van Boosters gives scholarships, and we fund this from the newspaper drive and the aluminum drive. And for those of you who don't know, that's located at Piedmont Village Shopping Center, right next to the Goodwill truck. It's there every third weekend of the month, and we appreciate you continuing to support that. Now, I'm not on this committee. Kathy Hooper is. She's the chairman, but she couldn't be here, and she gave me something. I'm supposed to read this exactly the way she wrote it. Lovely. In selecting the scholarship winners, we are looking for students who have gone beyond what is expected of them. We are looking for students who have participated in extra musical activities within the school band, and also in musical activities in the community. We are looking for students who have given something extra than or auxiliary in the way of leadership, enthusiasm, dedication, and hard work. This year, we are awarding 5 scholarships of $250 each, 3 musicians, and 2 auxiliary people. As I call the names, I should be students to come up here and just stay up here until we're all done, okay? The first one is Teresa Michelle Hinch. Teresa.
like George Allen with the Reds one time, Mr. Cook said he was going to give him an unlimited budget, but he was afraid he'd overspend it. And that's the way I always feel with these kids. They've done so much, and I'm just very pleased that these people have been recognized. We do have a system, the Boosters have established a system of recognizing each of the students who have participated in the events of the year, and as you know, have been many. Band letters, and after they receive a letter, they receive a bar to put on the letter each year. We only call off the seniors, but I will remind the other students, 9th, 10th, 11th graders, that your letters and your bars will be available. Mr. Nunzio, are they going to be up front, or are they going to be in the band room?
Out
in front, okay. At the reception, you can pick up your letters and your bars at the reception. Okay, here we go in alphabetical order. Loretta Billings receives a letter. Loretta. Matt Boissier. Brian Corlo, trumpet for that, sends a letter. And for our flag flag group. Kelly Guilford, Kelly, you here? Okay. Okay, I'll just meet you right there. Okay. One of our flag captains, Amy Griles. Another one of our senior members of the group, Nora Lotero. Nora, is she with us tonight?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll see her tomorrow. And one of our captains and new recipient of our scholarship awards, Mary Worley. Parkinson, who started out as a runner and then showed us she could do just as well as anybody else. Kathy? Kathy's not here. Okay. Virginia Tom. Not here. Okay. I will see those kids tomorrow. We have one student who, just to show you that you can play sports and still part of our organization, is one of the football players, varsity football players. And so I'm going to ask if Justin can come forward and receive this certificate. We have others that participate just in the stage band, but I think both of them have left. One of them almost didn't get here at all. Matt Roberts and Ryan Sullivan. Are you Matt or Ryan Keel here? Yes? Okay. If you get here late, you have to stay late to make up for it. Okay. See, I have a question to make, and I know you're sitting on pins and needles, but this is our officers for next year. And then we really are going to be missing for them. I have to do this. I'm going to name off all including the section leaders, because these are very important people to us also. Returning in the percussion section, sector Joel Venazio, if you're staying, and remain staying. Section leader for the low brass next year will be David Blankenship. Okay, they're getting ready for the next number. And the trumpets, section leader round. Number. And for saxophones, Danny Hickman. And the clarinets, it's Matt Lee. She passes it on to the next one, be Rebecca Powers. And we're lucky enough to hold on to the first, but still for another year. Heisen included. We have two sets of officers that are appointed by me. Have various sundry duties. For our managers, selected for next year will be Parker Curry and Brooks. Excuse me. Okay, for librarians, two gals up front, so I can get to them easily, Valerie Storer and Amy Flinchball. The next ones are the elected ones. Returning as treasurer, Julie McCormick. Secretary, Jennifer Tyler. The vice president, Mark Smith. President of our organization for next year, big man in percussion section, Joel DeNunzio. Uh, next announcement is the one that is the set of offices is achieved by audition. First one is no surprise to the drum major because he auditioned last year and served as alternate for this past year, so that he will be taking over as senior drum major for next year. That's Danny Guy. This is one of those years that through the audition, it was just very difficult. I think a number of these kids could probably be drum major and be very, very successful at it. But we had, of course, to go through the process of the scoring and serving as Danny's assistant next year, another trumpet player, Rob Newbold. That's expected to go to camp also, the drum major's camp, and learn the deal just as Danny did, and serve as alternate for next year to take over and serve as one of the drum majors for the following year. Serving as alternate for next year will be Heather Dreyer. Now we have, we're going to change the pace again and show you a little Dixie League and really, I'd say enough about those kids. They're so versatile. Let's play some music now, okay?
Thank you.
is a patriotic selection. Maybe the council I'm up to vote number five, Mrs. Hay. Home fellow, who's up there? And we'd like you at the end of our selection to join in song with us, the American Beautiful. And I did print the words there for you. This is a piece of music that I found several, and it has tape, it's a recorded tape, which is only operated up in the press box with a little up and low coming up right at the end. The tape of speeches and trying to work tape recorders and tapes into the set of speakers up above in here was an interesting afternoon. So I hope they come up to where you can hear what they said, because they are very, very true and effective speeches. This is Homer.
Thank you.
sit down. Energy when they do things like this. I don't understand how far past it is my bedtime. I would like to invite you all back to the open commons for a little reception.